Welcome friends, I am Tollens. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry and History of Molecules. So, this is a continuation of acetaldehyde condensation. Today we will discuss about Tollens condensation. But never get confused with Tollens condensation and Tollens reagent. That is a different silver mirror test. So, it's not that. It's an extended version of acetaldehyde condensation. Or most importantly, if we say, that is using formaldehyde. So, what we are going to discuss in this video, first the basic of Tollens condensation, mechanism and explanation, and finally with few examples. So, let's start. So, simply if we state the cross-aldol condensation, okay. So, this is, condition is one carbon should have alpha hydrogen, this is, and one carbon shouldn't have alpha hydrogen. So, what will happen? Base will analyze this and that will attack here. One problem may be there that this can undergo self-condensation, acetaldehyde, I agree. But that is only a problem. So that could be avoided by using selective base, this thing, or the addition of this with base and slowly addition of the aldehyde. So in this way, this is the local tricks we can follow to get. But then we can expect that this will react and produce this aldehyde. But actually this reaction does not happen. Okay. Does not occur. Now question why? Because of the extreme reactivity of formaldehyde. What do I mean? So if you look at the formaldehyde, this formaldehyde is very electron deficient, extremely. It is sometimes called superaldehyde. Okay, why? Because you can see these and these are hydrogen. Means they are not donating any electron. And second point, they are very small. So, means act one is positive charge density here. And second is bulk, less bulk mass of this hydrogen here. These two factors makes formaldehyde very electron deficient. And reality, if you check the other JEE diol formation from aldehyde, if you check, means this two, this JEE diol formation, you can see formaldehyde remains almost completely in JEE diol formation in presence of water. Although other aldehyde have some equilibrium. Even if you check chloral hydrate, due to the very high electron withdrawing group, means 3 chlorine, that prefers to remain in a JEE diol formation. But everybody has equilibrium, formaldehyde even completely. So these indicate this is so much electron deficient. Okay, and that is the reason this reaction happens. So what happens here? Here, in presence of base, if you provide, for example, base as a calcium chloride, this acetaldehyde will produce this enol. It's true. No problem. And enol is resonance stabilized with the carbonyl group. Now, if you put this formaldehyde, this, what will happen? We can expect that, okay, this will attack first and it will produce CH2, CHO and here CH2OH. Fine. It is true, it happens, and we expect after that it undergo base catalyzed dehydration to produce this, but that is not the problem, that doesn't happen. Even reaction doesn't happen, reaction does not stop here. Why? Because formaldehyde, actually we generally consider this attack of carbonyl, means enolate to the carbonyl, is RD step, means rate determining step in case of aldol condensation. But in case of formaldehyde, that problem is not there because attack is very easy, very less bulky. So this is not RD step. Actually, in case of this reaction with formaldehyde, is this RD step is the enolization. Enolize means actually here enolate. Enolate formation is the RD step here. So that's why if it conform enolate, reaction will happen. So this, and if you check this versus this, this, what do I mean? This acetaldehyde versus this, this is more electron deficient, like, because this CH2OH has a withdrawing effect, minus I effect, this group. Consequently, this is more, as these protons, for example, this proton is more acidic compared to parent acetaldehyde. And under alkaline condition, it will undergo enolization again. And since the enolization is the RD step, if enol could be prepared, then it will undergo reaction. And this phenomena continues until all the alpha hydrogen consumed. What do I mean? Means these three became CH2OH. Okay. So in this way, reaction continues until this all the alpha hydrogen exhaust. Now question is,
Can you compare this with anything? Yes, we can compare this factor. You can consider alpha halogenation of carbonyl. Means if take ketomethyl group, alpha halogenation carbonyl in presence of base. In presence of base, if you take bromine, then it undergo tribromination and end up there. And why end up there? Because no bromine is, no hydrogen is left for bromination. You can compare this concept here. And surprisingly, this reaction doesn't stop here. Means see that reactivity of formaldehyde is so much. Okay. So this is what can happen. Thing can happen that no alpha hydrogenation reaction is not here. But formaldehyde is there in the medium in excess. So what happens? Alkali can attack formaldehyde very easily. Why? As I told, very electron deficient, less bulky. So attack is very easy. And this step is not the hardest step we have showed here, because ionization is the hardest step. So what happens? This attacks, and after it produces CO minus OH and here 2 hydrogen. Okay, this is, now what happens? This pushes electron and this hydride migrates here to here and reduces. So, what product we are getting? We are getting here CH2OH thrice here, and the bond is with carbon. Don't get confused. This is carbon and this is also reduced to, means this is O minus and here hydrogen. After O minus abstracts proton from here, because this is the OH group bond. So, means it's a carboxylic. So, it produces CH2OH and this produces formic acid, or more precisely if we say actually formate, because the medium alkaline, this has abstracted this proton, even this can abstract this proton, or from water it can abstract this proton, but in alkaline medium it will remain. So, what happened? This first, this 3 alpha hydrogen convert to CHOH, they get this aldehyde reduced to this and this is called Cannizzaro reaction. Okay? So, in this way, it could be, this acetaldehyde could be converted into, this is, it is called pentaerythritol, means C, sorry, this should be another carbon. So, pentaerythritol, what do I mean? Means, if we write in an easier way, that is CH2OH4 carbon. Carbon is attached to this. So, this is a unique strategy and this is called the Tollens condensation reaction. So, we have understood the basic concept and mechanism of what is happening. So, ultimately, if we do the reaction, this doesn't occur. Instead of that, what occurs? This is CH2OH plus tetra plus formic acid. So, HCO, O minus I am writing as the medium is in base. Okay. So, I guess you have understood the basic point. Let's discuss some examples. Let's discuss these two examples. So, I believe with your eye will be covered. One thing I forget to explain, that is the nature of formaldehyde. Actually, formaldehyde is not available in monomeric form. What happened? It could be obtained in its trimeric form or polymeric form. Trimeric form, if I say, how does it look like? Actually, the trimer looks like this. This is oxygen, this is oxygen, this, sorry, I made this. This, not this. So, this is a trimer. And this formaldehyde CH2, you can consider this as CH2 and this is. So, what is actually this O is getting attacked by another oxygen such that these double bonds are broken and in this way single bonds are. So, you can consider it's an acetal type. Okay. So, this is in this way formaldehyde, it is in trimer, or you can have a polymeric formaldehyde. Okay. Fine. Now, let's discuss these two examples. As I told previously, that example is around using alkaline condition. So, if we take acid, what will happen? So, we have taken for polymer of formaldehyde and here this is trifluoroacetic acid. This is more acidic compared to acetic acid because of this trifluoride. So, here we, as we know that in presence of acid, reaction proceeds through ionization and more substituted carbon will undergo this ionization process. So, it is expected ionization will happen here. So, if enol is produced here, then this is, so we can think that this is the enol. So this will react with this formaldehyde and actually that happened. But as I told that it doesn't stop at this stage. Further enolization happened and ultimately it produces, actually this is, you can consider 2 hydroxyls are there. means these are the two hydroxyl, and these two hydroxyl is, you can see, 1,3 hydroxyl. So it can form acetal, and that's why these undergo acetal formation with another formaldehyde molecule to, and it results in this. So in acid medium, this acetal formation occurs. So in this way, this reaction happens. So this Tollens condensation type reaction not only happens in alkaline medium, can also happen in basic condition. Okay, so this is the example. Now the second example, which is little tricky, please focus. So here you can see aldehyde, and this is, this say 14 carbon, okay, level carbon, radioactive carbon. So formaldehyde we have taken, and we are doing this reaction, but surprising point is that this level is here. Okay, question, how? So let's discuss this mechanistically. So what I mean, in terms of alkali, what we will do? Alkali will abstract the alpha hydrogen here, and another thing, abstracting after alpha, after the abstraction of alpha hydrogen, the produced carbon ion is stable because of one factor, this aldehyde, second factor is aromaticity, because previously if you consider this is sp3 center, so 2 and 2 it can enjoy 4 but not conjugated, but if another 2 electron come, so this ring can also enjoy the aromaticity of 6 electron, so okay, fine, it will produce easily. Now as we think, then it will attack the CH2OH, so it attacks the CH2 and it opens up, so what will be the product? So after that attacking, it will produce CH2OH, and keep it in mind, this is the level carbon, level CH2OH. Now question, further what will happen? Since we have discussed that when alpha hydrogen is completely consumed, then the aldehyde will react, here also the same phenomenon will occur. So the aldehyde will be attacked by the alkali. So what it will produce? So this is CH2OH leveled, and here aldehyde. If aldehyde is getting attacked by alkali, so this, and it will be open up. So this is CO. This is O minus. This is O minus, and another. This is OH. Fine. Now the question is, we believe that the hydrogen means aldehyde hydrogen. These hydrogen will leave, and what will happen? This will reduce another formaldehyde, and the formaldehyde will be converted into formic acid. So what we have expected, that this formaldehyde, another formaldehyde means level formaldehyde. So it should have level, but in reality not. That is the twist. So what happens here? So this hydrogen is not leaving. Instead of that, it pushes its electron. This carbon is leaving its electron. So the negative charge. So what happens? In this way, the negative charge means, after that what it produces? This produces, means this, and the negative charge come here. Another thing, this is converted into formic acid. So this HCOOH. Under alkaline condition, it will not be stable. It will be converted into formic. Now question, why negative charge again coming here? Because the stabilization of this negative charge through aromatic stabilization, as I told earlier. So that's why, and after the, means first is the alkaline, second this is also a carbonyl, so after workup what happens, this negative charge consumes another proton and produces this. So ultimately this level CH2OH even attached to here. So this is a little tricky example, so try to understand this. So this is the end of the discussion. I hope you have understood. If you like my teaching, please please give a like, and thank you for listening my video. Additionally, please subscribe my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecule, and share this video among your friends so that many people could be benefited from my effort, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. See you in the next video with another topic. Okay, bye.